Hi, I'm Steve Jones, and I want to give you some tips on problem solving in mathematics. My first tip is do it step by step. Don't try and jump over steps. Don't try and do the easy ones in your head, because particularly if you're doing it in an examination, the examiner will want to see what you're doing. Okay, so here is a problem. V equals pi r squared h. Okay, so this formula is actually the formula for the volume of a cylinder. So it's a fairly straightforward problem, but how do we actually go about doing it? And the first thing we have to say is, as I've said, step by step. So if we're going to do this, substitute in step by step for pi. So you can have 3.142. R squared. Well, R squared we know is R times R. And it would be very tempting to just write here 4. But I'm tempted to write 2 by 2, 2 times 2. And then write H, the 6. At this stage, now is the time to just double check. Have I got pi? Yes. Have I got r? Yes. Squared? Yes. I've got 2. Have I got h? Yes. It's all there. At least I know to this stage I'm right. Even if I make a mistake later, the examiner will say, oh, all right, he's just made a slip and we won't knock too many marks off. So the next is to do the calculation. And obviously, 3.142, I'm not going to do anything with at the moment, but 2 times 4 we know is 4, and 6 is on the end. The reason I'm doing it in this way is because these might not be simple 2 times 2, it might be complicated numbers. So write that stage. The final stage, 3.142, 4 sixes are 24, and then work out this result. Now this gets us to an answer, and we work out whatever the answer is, somewhere around 80. But I'm not really bothered what the answer is. I'm interested in seeing what the process is, and so are people who look at your solutions to problems. So make sure the process is clear. At this point, I should be saying, well, this is going to be about, well, call that 25 and call that 3. 3 25's 75. Okay, it's about 75. At this point, if I use a calculator to get the answer, I will check that my guess at 75 is somewhere near the answer I get with a calculator. It's very easy to put something wrong in the calculator. So when you're doing problem solving in mathematics, number one, do it step by step. Number two, and you'll notice I'd already done this, I'd actually put a list of the different quantities on the right-hand side with their units. This is again something which is easy to check at the end. So here we are, how to solve problems in maths and not get docked marks for bad work.